Well, I think right now, at least two companies that we know of have been very public about their trials and their programs. So ViaCyte is in a clinical trial. Vertex, I think, according to their previous statements, they seem to be able to go into the clinic really soon. And then multiple really large pharmaceutical companies that are in the diabetes space all have stem cell programs. So,
yeah.
You know, Novo Nordisk has a program. Lilly is working with Sigilon, you know, a biotech startup. And then I think Sanofi has a collaboration with another company called Evotec. And so they also have a stem cell program. So I think it's definitely very encouraging that so many commercial entities with really large financial resources
yes.
are going into it. I think previously, you know, like I mentioned earlier, most of these companies, they put a lot of bets on encapsulation as an approach. And then I think I would just, you know, whenever I see some of these colleagues, I would say that, you know, you should sort of also look at non-encapsulation methods. I think it's, don't put all your eggs in one basket,
yeah, yeah,
right?
Definitely.
And, but I really think success will come really soon because there's so many people trying it. And then this is, now I think it's more of a technically feasible approach, right? Like we probably just need to throw enough money and time to really solve the problem, and we'll eventually get there. I'm not worried that you know, we're going to see the insulin independence of a diabetes patient like from receiving these type of cell transplants really soon. So I'm really excited about
yeah.
that.